Do I finally have proper setting? Yes, I do. Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. My name is Reggie, naturally Reggie. And today we're going to be, we're going to be customizing my iPad. So as you can see, wait. Can I make it clear? That is the iPad Pro 2020, 12.9 inch. So with the iPad 2, I got the Pro case, and I know the first thing, like I just should have known, the Pro case is so, it's not grease proof. Like this thing gets so greasy, like it's nobody's business. And it's not even a trifold. I thought it was a trifold, and it's not a trifold, so I failed. But anyways, we'll talk more about my iPad and Apple accessories, tech accessories. So as you can see, I don't really got anything going on. I just found this pretty generic accessories. Is that how today I am filming a Customize My iPad 2020 with me, and we're talking about widgets. Me, I told myself I wasn't gonna do this, but we're doing it because my face likes to be pleased. My eyes like to be pleased. So with my iPad Pro 2020, I do have an Apple Pencil with a black pencil grip. This is the second generation Apple Pencil, the one that you're able to, supposed to easily be a magnet. So the first thing you're gonna want to figure out, of course, is your aesthetics. I like dark. I know, I like dark. And actually, I have not done any customizing of widgets on my phone either, but I used to be an Android user. I know that was years ago. The last time I had an Android, 2013. I want a dark theme and matte and gloss. Dark, matte, and gloss with black, my mustard color, and that's it. Maybe white. Maybe. I just want a sleek, clean, minimal look. All right, so first things first. Apple has a whole bunch of third-party apps that can provide this for you, right? So the first thing you're going to go and do, actually, let me see if I have a widget. I'm going to go to the Apple Store. We're going to find the third-party widget app that you want to use. And widgets are basically just the small, when you scroll over to the side, the small section that you do see here on the side. So I'm not only customizing this part, I am going to also be customizing the icons on my screen. So back to the Apple Store, and I am going to use what I do know, which is Widget Smith, and you have 20,000 people who have reviewed it. So we're hoping that it's bomb. Again, there are so many other third-party apps that you can use. I am just going to use Widget Smith because I've heard of Widget Smith. That's all I can tell you. We're going to be testing it out as we go. So hey, we are going to open Widget Smith and see what they have for us. And this makes it simple because they have what it is that we need. Do I want to go small to large? Honestly, all these premium stuff is, interesting. And also keep in mind that there are specific widget apps, third party, for specific widgets. So like your calendar, the weather, battery life support. No, battery life, like gauging your battery life on, like if you have multiple Apple products, right? Which is, I think that is so Apple. First of all, let me even explain that I love the ecosystem that Apple provides. Honestly, look at me, I sound like a diehard fan. So let's get this calendar widget up. I'm huge on calendars because I don't know where my life would be. I don't know where I'd be going if I don't have calendars happening. I'm gonna hit the veins in my hands. So we are going to actually add a medium widget. So we have these widgets, I guess. I'm gonna add the medium widget. And I'm switching up a matte black wallpaper. I like this. Kind of has a vignette to it. I like that. So I'm actually, so we're gonna save this. I'm gonna first set the background that I want. And I honestly just have a, that's me, mind your business. A black, this is not good because it looks like someone tried to content aware. That's a bad pic. That's a bad picture. It looks like someone tried to content aware the watermark on it. Okay, I like this. It's almost hair like. It's pretty cool to me. So we're gonna click edit. No, we're not gonna click edit. We're gonna click the share button, and then we are going to use it as a wallpaper. I will set that for both the, I actually wanted to set that for both the lock screen and the home screen. So we'll put that under set both for both the lock screen and the home screen. Now you're making me feel, No, I'm saying, can I go into Photoshop, create my own icons and import them? With this, hey, you can click that. This is the default widget now, okay? We're on Widget Smith. This is your default widget, or you can choose to hit the widget. Let me go back and show you that. Hit default widget and a whole bunch of shiznit pops up. Let me actually close that because I have to remember to use that. I already have that as my one of my widgets, right? So because I do want another medium widget, I will click on add medium widget, which I just did. I'm gonna click on that calendar widget and then I will click on default widget. Because my number, medium number two, now needs a default widget. So that's what you're gonna click on. And now your default widget would be whatever it is that you want. So mine is going to be, quarter to five. Heck no, I'm not doing that. That's my location, that's my time. I have my location on. Font, future. They have Futura. That's one of my favorite fonts. White. Time format. I do like my 24 hour time. So we're going to use 24 hour time. I'm in Toronto. Tint color. White is good. White is good. This is pretty much set for me because I am going for this type of feel, right? And yeah, so that's done and I can hit save. And then what else do I want? I want, let's see what they have for small again. So we already have our time. We have our date, which is our calendar. That's what we've done with our widget, our widgets. So now we would just repeat the same step of how we even got our widget to the side dock. So we're gonna hit edit after we've scrolled down our add. And then we're going to scroll down to Widgetsmith. And we are going to hit add widget. And then we're going to hit, hey buddy, edit widget. And hit medium two. There we go. So that makes a lot of sense. And I'm actually going to go ahead, edit that. And drag this to the top. now that we want to start editing and changing the actual icons, I can honestly just go into like Photoshop and do this, or I can just download icons. Time consuming. I'm gonna download icons. So I'm gonna be using a website that I found online from a YouTuber called Simply Pops. And we are going to actually download and browse by theme. So I want my nice dark metal. Let's see. No, that's really giving me old Android vibes. Dark Knight Rises. Let's see. Application icons. And here you will see all the application icons. This is nicer than I thought. Or should I really do want a matte. Like, I'm not gonna lie. But I think a matte would be very hard on my eye. Remember, my eyes, right? Speaking of eyes, if you do not have glasses for blue light, what is you really doing? iOS theme, I believe. All right, so to download the icons, you're gonna wanna just scroll down a bit and you're gonna hit show quick actions. And we're gonna select all. All right, so let me just better explain this. You're gonna see a button that does say show quick actions. You're gonna see select all of your icons, and then for the labels, aka the captions of the icon, you can either choose to have it empty or have it there. In this video, these are actually not the icons that I ended up going with, but you can choose your icons that you do want, and you can choose whether or not you want to have the labels with the icons. Once you figure that out, you're just gonna scroll on down, then you're gonna hit generate theme. And once you hit generate theme, you're gonna be prompted with a notification that will tell you to download the icon or to install the icon, and your icons are downloaded. So once your icons are downloaded, you're gonna then head over to your settings section, and you're gonna see a new pop-up, a new tab called profile downloaded. Once you select that, you're going to see the icon profile downloaded, the theme that you downloaded, the website that it's from, and hun, rest assured, because it is verified. So you're going to hit install. Once you hit install, you're going to be asked to probably put in your password, and then hit install again, and your icons, voila. Voila. Okay, I was just on a go, and I realized I was going, and I realized I wasn't filming. Reached the point. We've reached the point of where we are going to create our own icons. Okay. And we're gonna do this pretty quickly.
Oh my god.
Chrome is gonna be the first one. We're gonna use you. Okay, got it. We're just gonna now Google Chrome. Google Chrome icon. And no, honey. That's ugly. So ugly. And that's weird. And whatever. And then we're just gonna save that to your iPad. Okay, so now that you've saved your icon from Google, you're gonna head to Procreate. Don't understand what's going on here. Ignore it. We are going to get a square size. Zoom out. We're going to insert a photo. Girl, you are just too much. And then we're going to zoom this photo on out. And Procreate has this nice new tool, actually, that'll make life easy. So we're going to hit this adjustment icon, the third icon from the gallery button, and you're gonna hit gradient map. And now that you have gradient map, you have some colors. So it has now adjusted the icon in itself, and there are so many different colors that you can choose from, things that you can do, pretty, but we are gonna create our own. So then you come to the generic gradient, and I am actually would have actually been a great thing to do was to remove all the other icons into its own folder. I'm going to name that folder home screen, whatever. And that's done. So now it's just smooth. Like, I just want whatever I need to just be there. So I'm just gonna give you one more quick example of customizing your own icons that were not available within the downloaded pack. You are just gonna upload your image to Procreate. You're gonna hit adjustments, hit gradient map, and make sure that you are adjusting that layer in itself. And once you hit that, you'll see a whole bunch of colors. But in my case, I'm keeping all my icons white and just making sure that my background is black. And then last but not least, don't forget to save the final image as a JPEG onto your iPad. Now that you have your customized icon complete, you're going to want to be able to make sure that those icons do open to the right apps. All you have to do is just enter the Shortcuts app, click the plus sign at the top left corner. You're then going to want to find the action that opens an app. You can search for open app, and I would suggest to keep that as a favorite because you are going to be doing that with many of the other icons that you have created. Once you've done that, it's going to ask you to choose which app you want to open or create the shortcut for. You select your app and then add to home screen. Here you're going to choose the photo that you want, which is going to be the icon that we just created on Procreate. You're going to write the name of the shortcut, and then you're gonna save it. And once that's done, you're all done. That wraps it for the iPad 2020 customizing of the home screen. I don't know if it was this workout that I did, but I am so sore and sitting in this chair is not helping. It can be time consuming, I'm not gonna lie. It can be time consuming. Yeah, it's really not that bad. I do like this dark theme compared to what I had before. I don't know what was going on before, but I do like this. But I hope you guys liked this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you like it and make sure you share it with someone. But I'll see you guys in the next video.